Who needs to change their name in the NFL? What about Elisha Manning? How about he just accepts the change to Eli? There are plenty of NFL players who don't use their actual names. Julio Jones was born Quintoris Lopez. The NFL players have their way of becoming household names. After all, every weekend they enter our TV screens and put on entertaining performances that we love to watch. But some of the players, even the most popular guys in the league who are in the NFL nowadays, may not be exactly who they appear. There are a number of them who aren't even using their real names. Some guys use their middle names instead of their first name for whatever reason. There are other players that have names that have seemingly come out of nowhere. Juju? Buddha? Anyway, let's take a look at 12 current NFL players who have decided against their given names and taken a whole new identity. Juju Smith, who you may or may not know, was born with the simplest given name of all time, John Smith. Yeah, apparently he was not John for long though. Reporters say that he had an aunt who, when Juju was 6 months old, started calling him Choo-Choo because he used to play with toy trains a lot, and that sort of just melted into Juju. Juju, however, was born long before his hyphenated surname was, and for the first 18 years of his life, Juju only had one last name, Smith. And while he always wanted to change his name to Schuster, his stepfather's last name, his biological father would not allow him to do so, but once he turned 18, Juju was free to do what he wanted. And thus, Juju Smith-Schuster was born, and the jobs of announcers all over the country immediately became just a little bit more challenging. Eugene Marquis Hilton. That's exactly what you would hear if T.Y. Wendt went by his real name. Yeah, you got that right. T.Y. Hilton's real name is Eugene Marquis. For those keeping score at home now, there is clearly not a T.Y. in that name. What's interesting about Hilton, though, is that for a little while, no one really knew the backstory of him going by T.Y. That was until Mike Bees, a reporter from The Republic, an area paper in Columbus, Indiana, caught up with Hilton after he delivered a key performance during his rookie season in 2012. When prompted, Hilton explained his daddy's name is Tyrone. So ever since he was little, everyone had just used the first two letters of that. Regarding the periods in T.Y. and their origin story, Hilton himself didn't actually have a clue. He guessed at some point either Tyrone or his mom Cora figured it was a nice accent to the name and threw them in there. Debo Samuel, on the other hand, well, that's not a family heirloom the way that T.Y. was, nor does it have any sort of genetic relationship to his nickname the way Juju took the soft J sound from John for his nickname. The 49ers' second-round draft pick in the 2019 NFL Draft, Debo Samuel was actually born Tyshon Samuel. Debo was the neighborhood bully from the movie Friday, which Samuel has said he has watched upward of 1,000-plus times. He continued to explain that pretty much every stop along the way growing up, especially high school to college, he thought that Debo was going to go away and people would start calling him by his birth name, Tyshon. But that moment never came. And now that he has firmly established himself in the NFL as Debo, I don't think we're going to see a change coming anytime soon. Now, just because he expected it to go away doesn't mean that he doesn't like Debo. In fact, he admitted it's kind of a cool name. And based on the way he looked on the field during his first couple of NFL seasons, prepare to hear that name Debo on the airwaves for some time to come. Julio Jones was born as Quintoris Lopez Jones, but there are probably very few people out there who know him as that or call him by that name. That's because he's been Julio for pretty much as long as he's been in the public spotlight, which is a long time. Considering the fact that he practically reached legendary status for his insane athleticism while growing up in Foley, Alabama. In fact, the name dates all the way back to 7th grade, when his loving mother, who had an extravagant name herself, Queen Marvin, gave him the nickname. It was especially peculiar because Julio was historically a Latino name, a heritage that Jones apparently does not have an ounce of blood from, but nevertheless, she slapped it on him and it sort of stuck. He came out publicly and said that he does not like his birth name, as it means gladiator. Julio, if that's what we're going to call him by, is not the only star wide receiver in the league who goes by a moniker that's seemingly completely unrelated to their given name. Not by a long shot. Just ask T.Y. Hilton, Debo Samuel, and Juju Smith-Schuster. Arizona Cardinals defensive back Buda Baker, who is widely renowned for not only being a solid football player, but also has one of the coolest names in the NFL, also goes by a name that has no relation to his birth name. Bashard Baker has really leaned into the whole Buda thing now. So much so that he doesn't like to be called Bashard nowadays. Skip Bayless's beloved quarterback Dak Prescott. Well, Dak was actually born Rain Dakota Prescott. And yes, you say it like rain. According to a piece he did with the Dallas Morning News, he was never into being called Rain. Just from the get-go, immediate rejection. When I started off school, they would always call me Rainy or Riney or something. They would be like, this is a girl's name, so I just always went by Dakota. But I was given Dak by birth, so my family's always called me Dak. Now that he's gotten older, Dak explains he feels he's grown into his given name. He went as far to suggest that one day he might start going by Rain Dakota and skip the last name. Dak is not the only NFL quarterback that uses their middle name or some variation of it instead of their given first name. In fact, there are quite a few notable quarterbacks that made the change. Longtime Lions quarterback who is now a Los Angeles Ram, Matthew Stafford was actually born John Matthew Stafford. There isn't much out there to what went into his decision to forego the name John, so it was likely a choice made very early when he was a child. It's worth noting, though. Rumor has it that Stafford doesn't actually like even being called Matt, which nearly every sportscaster in America defaults to. Instead, his family calls him Matthew, which is what he prefers. Mr. Massage Man himself, Deshaun Watson. His birth name was actually Derek Deshaun Watson. I'll be honest, this one really caught me off guard. You almost never hear ties to the name Derek mentioned, which again might be a good thing. Watson has all sorts of public relations and brand issues going on with the allegations against him, so maybe he should just go full rebrand to Derek and hope that people forget all the nasty accusations that Deshaun has been tied to recently. It isn't just the quarterbacks that we have seen roll in with middle names in lieu of their birth names, though. Take Kansas City Chiefs speedster Mecole Hardman, for example. The wide receiver and kick return specialist was actually born Kerry Mecole Hardman Jr. He didn't really have much of a choice but to go by Mecole either. His father was apparently a legend in the Georgia high school football world, and he, like his son, went by Mecole, so it was only natural for him to try and carry on the family name as best he could. Similarly, Chris Godwin, the Tampa Bay Buccaneers star receiver, was born Rod Christopher Godwin. Like Hardman, decided to go with the middle name instead. Not going to lie, Rod Godwin sounds pretty catchy for a football star. I don't know why he didn't go with that, but it doesn't seem like he had any deep family ties to the middle name like the Chiefs' wideout. But he has been Chris since day one. Yeah, I definitely wish he went by that original name. Rod Godwin. The whole Chris thing has been working pretty well for him so far, so maybe he should just stick with it. The last middle name guy on our list here is Raheem Mostert. He was born Dominique Raheem Mostert, which is a mouthful. Mostert probably didn't put too much thought into which name he goes by these days. After being cut by six teams before finally making his breakthrough onto an NFL roster, he's probably just content with where he's at. Last but not least, we have Cincinnati Bengals wide receiver T. Higgins, who might have the coolest, vague name on this entire list. T just works for a star receiver, but just because he's grown into the name and established himself as a promised young receiver in the league, doesn't mean that it wasn't his birth name. He was actually born T. Maurice William Higgins, and his name just got shortened down to T somewhere. The only debate here is whether he should have gone harder on it and shortened it all the way down to just the letter T, which would have been pretty cool too, but T with two E's is pretty cool. It's fine. We've seen plenty of two-letter guys in the league over the years, but a player with just a single letter for his name, that would actually be pretty groundbreaking. So that's what we came up with, folks. What was your favorite fake name? Who did we miss? Is there a player that you think needs to change their name? Drop us a comment down below and let us know what you think about the video. If you enjoyed the video, or even if you didn't, go ahead and smash that like button and consider subscribing. Until next time.